पेरेंट्स हैं फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, कमिटेड द मिस्टेक ऑफ ब्रिंगिंग अनदर पर्सन इनटू दिस वर्ल्ड ऑफ agony, longing and suffering, that they compensate by investing themselves in raising the kid. That is why it is imperative for the parents to bring education to the kid, give food to the kid, spend money on the kid. It is a compensation. Have you seen how much of parents' time, especially the mother's time, gets spent on the kid? It has to be done. It is a thing of justice. It is not a favor to the kid. The parents owe it to the kid. And the kid is very justified in asking, did I really plead to you to bring me into this world? Did I send a formal application? You, in your moment of personal wisdom and planned indiscretion or unplanned lust, gave birth to me. Now I sue you. Now I demand damages, and all the money that gets spent on the kid is actually a compensation. Compensation for that moment of indiscretion. It could be conscious indiscretion by way of a planned birth, or it could be unconscious indiscretion when you say, oh, the child just came, we didn't plan it. Whether conscious or unconscious, the fact is that it is an indiscretion. Because it is an indiscretion, so you pay for it. Now you know why you have to pay so much for the kid's school fee. It is a fine. It is a fine that you are paying. You are being penalized by existence. Now you know why the mother has to carry the kid for 9 months. The mother is being severely penalized. What made you go so blind in emotion or in lust that you allowed yourself to get pregnant? Now pay the fine. Now a shrieking, screeching thing will come into the world. Pay the fine. It begins by paying the hospital fees. No kid gets born without the hospital charges being paid. Does that not tell you that the whole thing starts as some kind of penalty? See, after you fight with someone, you are carried away to the hospital. You know that something wrong has happened, that's why you have been brought to the hospital. And when you get pregnant, you are taken to the hospital. Don't you see the parallel? So that's true. And every kid must ask this. And therefore, giving the best environment to the kid to rid him of all body and social identification is the minimum that the parents can do for him. The parents have given the kid the cage that the body is. The body is a cage, and as the kid grows up, there is much more to engage him. And it's not merely a mistake, it's actually a crime. There was nobody to suffer. And you unnecessarily brought suffering to the world. Now the minimum that you can do is liberate him. Give him conditions that would enable his liberation. And that is the role, the dharma of parents. Give kid conditions that would enable his liberation. I repeat, this is not a favor that parents do to the child. This is their obligation. And if you cannot meet this obligation, then you are committing a double crime. The first is to give birth. The second is to give birth without having the credentials to act as worthy parents. Let all parents remember this. The day the child is born, he is born as someone to whom you are deeply indebted. You have to clear the debt. It is not that the child is indebted. The parents must be very clear on who the debtor is. Classically, it has been said that the child owes a lot to the parents. Matra rin, pitra rin. The fact is totally different. The parents owe a lot to the child. So be very cautious while giving birth. When you are giving birth, you are actually giving birth to a big debt, a humongous debt. And you'll have to settle that debt. Otherwise, you won't be able to settle in peace.